So metallurgy is the process of extraction of metals from their corresponding ore. Why we are using that corresponding ore? Because different metals have different types of ore. So for extraction of metal, so we had to use the particular that ore only. That's why we are using the word corresponding. Okay. So I'm going to write definition for metallurgy here. So what is metallurgy? The process of extraction of metals from their corresponding ore. From their corresponding ore is, or we can say are called as metallurgy. Understood, everyone? Metallurgy?
Yes, sir.
Okay, yes, sir.
So now we are going to discuss about the types of metallurgy.
Should we rewrite the definition of metallurgy, or we should
I think you have already written in last class. If you want to write, you can write one more time. Okay. So types of metallurgy. Okay. So on the basis of different method, okay, we have divided metallurgy into three basic types. Number one, we have pyrometallurgy. Pyrometallurgy. I will explain you one by one, don't worry. Second one, we have hydrometallurgy. Hydrometallurgy. And last but not the least, we have electrometallurgy. Metallurgy. It is the third part. Okay. So we will understand all this type of metallurgy one by one. Okay. So first we are going to understand pyrometallurgy. Okay. So the word pyro, which means heat. Here the word pyro means heat. And we have already gone through with the definition of metallurgy. Okay. So the process in which if metal are extracted by heating the ore strongly, whether it may be present of oxygen or in absence of oxygen, okay, that if we are using the heat, then it is called as pyrometallurgy. Okay, so I'm going to write definition over here. So you have to just remember the meaning of pyro. Pyro means heat, okay, and here hydro means water, and here
electro means electricity, using electricity.
Yes. Okay, like electrolytic reduction, we are going to understand about electrolytic reduction of alumina. We will understand that after the completion of types of metallurgy. Okay, so I'm going to write definition for pyrometallurgy. Okay, so the metallurgical process in which ore is heated strongly in order to extraction of metal is called as is.
Sir, can you give an example?
Yes, I will give you example also, don't worry. Okay, is called as pyrometallurgy. Okay, suppose we have example, we have silicon, sulfur, oxygen, metal, zinc. Zinc is present in sulfide form. So it is a zinc sulfide. It is called as zinc blend. Zinc blend. Okay. So zinc blend is the ore for the extraction of zinc metal. Okay. So here that ore, zinc sulfide, is heated strongly. ZnS is heated strongly in presence of excess of oxygen. Then sulfur is going to oxidize in order to form sulfur dioxide. SO2 gas will release. Okay. SO2 gas will release, and that zinc again get oxidized in order to form ZnO. Okay. So ZnO then again treated with like a carbon particle. It is heated with carbon particle in order to form carbon dioxide. And then zinc is extracted at its pure form. Okay, so here we are heating the ore strongly in presence of oxygen. So I'm writing here heat. Okay, so this is the method of like we are using heat for the extraction of metal. Okay, understood that ZnO again heated with carbon. Yes,
sir. Then in the first process, when zinc sulfide that zinc blend is heated in the presence of excess oxygen, Where is that sulfur dioxide released, because that's a pollutant?
Yeah, it is released into the atmosphere only, because sulfur dioxide is stored in the container and it is used for the formation of sulfuric acid.
Okay, sir.
Okay, yeah. If like most of the industries, they used to release into directly into the atmosphere. But some of the industries like purification industries, they used to store that sulfur dioxide and they use it for the formation of sulfuric acid. Okay, that SO2 is converted into SO3, then it is treated with oxygen and water vapors, and then they form sulfuric acid. It is very long process and you will understand in higher classes, don't worry. Okay, so we are not going to study that much deep, because it is part of 12th class and we are in 8th. Okay, so see here, then ZnO again treated with carbon in order to form zinc and carbon monoxide. If we will use excess amount, then carbon dioxide will release. Okay, that carbon dioxide again release into the atmosphere, and we are getting, see, that zinc. Again here we used to heat strongly. So in both of the process, we used to heat ore and zinc oxide strongly in order to form zinc.
From which gas will be released?
Carbon dioxide. In second process, carbon dioxide, and in first process, sulfur dioxide.
Okay.
So it is pyrometallurgy. You do not have to remember this reaction. You just have to remember only the extract, like metallurgy process, in which ores are heated strongly in order to extraction of metal. Okay, it is pyrometallurgy. Then we have hydrometallurgy. Okay, so hydrometallurgy is generally used for the concentration of ore. Okay. And we are, let me write first here, the process in which metals or maybe ore are concentrated in current of water. In current of water. Okay, then it is called as hydrometallurgy. Hydrometallurgy. Okay, see, whatever the ore we are getting after mining, okay, that ore first crushed into the powder form by the ball mill. Ball mill is there. Okay, it works like that atta chakki. Okay, so that ore, which is very solid and in big pieces, it has to crush into the powder form. That powder form of ore, which is washed with current of water, so the water soluble impurities, they move along with the water. Okay, and the heavy particles, they settle down at the bottom. That is nothing but the concentrated ore. So generally we used to like wash that powder form of ore in order to remove water soluble impurity from it. Okay, that's what is called as hydrometallurgy, because we are using current of water. Understood, everyone?
Sir, can you write that how it is done, please?
Okay. Suppose here.
Sir, can you scroll up?
Okay.
Can you minimize? I want to take a screenshot.
We have one more part, which is electrometallurgy. After that, you can take a screenshot. I will show you in a one shot only. Don't worry. Okay. So I'm going to explain how like hydrometallurgy done. Okay. Suppose.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, beta.
Sir, from which substance did you compare that thing, sir, which you told just now? Something like atta, something you have compared. I didn't understand.
Atta chakki. It is in the ball mill. It is called as ball mill.
Okay, sir.
Okay. In ball mill, there are two stone or metallic rollers are there. Okay. And in between the roll, that ore are being, you know, dropped over here through the arrangement called hooper. Let me show you here. So this is the hooper. Okay, here ore particles are present. Okay, and through hooper, that ore particles, they are passes through in between that these two stone or maybe the granite or maybe metallic crushers are there. Okay, that ore is passes through here. Okay, it is present inside the box, and from here the powdered ore is being formed. Powdered ore is formed. That powdered ore then washes with water. Okay. So here, suppose here we have the, it is called as hydraulic classifier. It is hydraulic classifier. Here, one outlet is present over here. Okay. And that hydraulic classifier is filled with that powdered ore over here. Okay. And water, current of water is supplied through the pipe. Okay, and here one spin wheel is present, spin wheel. Okay, that spin wheel keeps rotating. Okay, and the like water soluble impurities.
Sir,
yes,
sir, what did you call this container? Hydrolic what?
Hydraulic classifier. It is called as hydraulic classifier.
Okay, sir,
hydraulic classifier. Okay, this is arrangement called hydraulic classifier. Okay, here one spin wheel is present, which is connected with the electric motor. Okay, and here one arrangement of like pipeline is arranged over here in order to supply water. Okay, and here that powdered ore is present. When spin wheel is rotating and we are supplying water of current continuously, and you know the water soluble impurity that dissolve in water. Okay, and from that outlet, that impurities moves along with water. Okay, like water soluble impurity we have, light impurity we have, that flows along with the current of water from here, and the heavy metallic ore which settle down at the bottom and which can be separated time to time. So here we are using water, the current of water. Okay, that's why it is called as hydrometallurgy. Understood, everyone? What is hydrometallurgy?
Yes, sir. Actually, this is used in gold mining, right, sir?
I think it is used in whatever the ore which contain water soluble and light impurity. All the ores are being concentrated by using hydraulic classifier. We have wheel play table. We have like froth flotation method. There are different methods we use water over there. Okay, almost all the ores, they contain water, because whatever that ore we are getting, which is from the like different layer of the earth surface. Okay, so they contain water soluble and light impurity. So for the removal of water soluble impurity and light impurity, we are washing that powdered ore. First, we have to convert that ore into powdered form. Okay, then we are using current of water in order to remove impurity, like they are water soluble or light impurity. They move along with water from here. Okay, so I am writing here impurities. Okay, and the concentrated ore which is settled down at the bottom. It is also called as gravity separation method. You know why gravity separation method? Because impurity is light and the metallic part is heavy. it is heavier as compared to the gangue or impurity. That's why it settled down at the bottom, and we can separate out from here time to time. So here I am writing the.
So it is gravity separation, no?
It is called as gravity separation method, but water is used here. That's why it is also called as hydrometallurgy. Okay.
Sir, what is current of water?
Current of water means the water which is flowing is called as current of water.
At a high speed.
Stream of water, we can say. Okay. Not electric current.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So, any doubt here? So, very important point we have discussed here, that, you know, the ore which is obtained after mining, which is, you know, where solidic form like these particles are present. So that large particle had to be converted into powdered form. That's why we are using that ball mill. It is called as ball mill. Okay. Here we have written ball mill. So that ball mill works like atta chakki.
You said as powder we will throw in water, sir. What if we throw as small stones?
Haan beta.
Sir, you said that powder we will give in water, sir. Then if we throw small stones, sir.
All will crush down by the ball mill. Ball mill contain a very strong, you know, like a stone or stone wheel. So whatever will enter inside will crush down into powder form. Okay?
Okay, sir.
Okay. So now we are going to, so this diagram is, like if you want to take a screenshot, you can take a screenshot. It is only to understand what is hydrometallurgy. It is not the part of your syllabus. Okay. I'm just, you know, explain you. I have just explained you in order to understand what is hydrometallurgy. Okay. Understood everyone?
Sir, doubt.
Okay. So have you taken a screenshot? Everyone. Okay. So now.
Can you show us today's and today's full part?
Today's full part, yes. I will show you. But before that, we have to cover that electrometallurgy also, okay? So we are going to understand what is electrometallurgy is all about. Okay? Yes, beta. What is your doubt?
Sir, there are many types of in metallurgy. So why people use different types? Why can't they use one type?
Will you please repeat your question and a little louder?
There are many types of metallurgy. So why metallurgy. People use all the types? They can't use one.
See, because different metal contain different types of impurity. That's why we had to use, you know, whichever the metallurgy is going to suit to in order to extraction of metal, we are using only that one.
Sir, how many types of total metallurgies are there?
Metallurgical process? We have mentioned here only three.
Only three, sir. No.
No. We have like magnetic separation method, we have, but it is not in use syllabus. We have one more like method called magnetic separation method. Okay, in magnetic separation method, we are
sure that magnetic impurities would be separated from the ore.
Maybe magnetic or non-magnetic. So we have one principle in order to use that magnetic separation method. Okay, if like ore contain metal, let me write over here. See, ore contain metal as well as impurity. So among like from anyone, like in metallic part or in impurities, one must contain magnetic property, then we can use magnetic separation method. Maybe ore or like maybe metallic part or maybe impurity, anyone must contain magnetic property and another will be non-magnetic one. Then we are going to...
I have one more doubt. Is silicon metal or non-metal or metalloid?
Metalloid, beta. It is metalloid. Okay. Yeah. Okay, so let's discuss what is electrometallurgy. Okay, so what is electrometallurgy? It is the process of extraction of metal. The process of
using electricity.
Process of extraction of metals from their ore. From their ore by using electrolytic reduction. Electrolytic reduction is called as electrometallurgy. It is electrolytic reduction. Let me explain you that one also. Wait a second. I am writing first example. Like all the heavy, like all the reactive metals, all very reactive metals. Reactive.
Sir, alkali metals, right?
Yes. Metals are alkali as well as alkaline earth metals. So all very reactive metals are extracted by electrometallurgy process. Electrometallurgy process. Okay. So you wanna go through that? What is electrometallurgy is all about with example?
Sir?
Yes, beta?
Sir, what word did you write after using?
Using electrometallurgy. Oh, sorry, electrolytic reduction.
So what is electrolytic reduction?
Yes, I will explain you. Wait a second. Electrolytic reduction. It is a very important process. Okay. So let's discuss what is electrolytic reduction all about. Okay. Suppose we have NaCl. Okay. Suppose it is the salt which is obtained from the ocean water. Is it?
Yes, sir.
If we, if we want to extract sodium metal from NaCl, we have to use electrometallurgy. Okay, let me explain you how. So suppose here we have the electrolytic tank. Okay.
Sir, can you explain what
is called as that electrolysis, which is used for electrolysis?
Yes, yes. So I'm labeling also, wait a second. It is electrolytic tank. It is the tank where electrolysis.
Explain what is that tank?
Beta, let me explain you first. After completion of explanation, you have to ask question. If you doubt, don't ask in between, beta. Okay. Understood? Let me explain metallurgy, like electrometallurgy first, and then if you are getting any doubt, then you have to ask me, na? Okay. Okay. So it is electrolytic tank. Electrolytic tank. Okay, here we have one electrode. I will explain you each and every part. Let me draw the diagram first. It is the electrode and which is positively charged, and positively charged electrode is called as anode. It is anode, and anode is positively charged electrode. Here we have another electrode which is negatively charged, and it is called as cathode. Cathode is negatively charged electrode. Okay. And these electrodes are connected through by the external source of electricity. So it is the battery. Here we have key so that we, according to the requirement, we can switch on and switch off the current. And here we have the galvanometer in order to detect whether current is passing through it or not. Okay, so here we have galvanometer. Galvanometer. Here this is the positive terminal and negative terminal of the battery. So it is battery. Here we have key. So that according to which we can switch on and switch off the light. And here we have taken aqueous solution of NaCl. Aqueous solution of NaCl. What's wrong?
So suddenly your arrow is stopped and even screen sharing also.
Yeah, your screen sharing is stopped.
Yes. Wait a second. I think OneNote has closed. Wait a second. Let me share one more time. It's restarting. Wait a second. Okay. So, is there any doubt if you want to So, here we have taken aqueous solution of.
Sir, should we write whatever you are writing?
First, you will take screenshot after that. Just you have to understand only. After that, you can take a screenshot. Okay. See, we have taken aqueous solution of NaCl. Aqueous solution of NaCl means we have to dissolve NaCl in water. And we know when NaCl is dissolved in water, NaCl breaks down in order to form sodium positive ion and chlorine negative ion in aqueous form. Is it?
Yes, sir, as it is an ionic compound.
Yes. Because so that it dissociates which one? Sodium chloride dissociate when it is dissolved in water. That means in that aqueous solution of NaCl, we have positively charged ion and negatively charged ion. Is it or not? Positive as well as negatively charged ion.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Okay. So when we will switch on the current, see, I have switched on the current means I have joined, there is a key is present. That key is called as plug key. We had to plug so that in order to flow the current through the circuit. Okay. So we have switched on the key, means current will flowing through the circuit. So that cathode, it is a negatively charged electrode. So here, positive ions will going to attract toward the negative electrode, and negative ions, they are going to attract toward the positive electrode. Is it or not? Because opposite charges, they attract each other and same charges repel each other. Is it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So let me scroll so that we have place for writing. So now I'm going to write a reaction. Which reaction will going to take place on anode? We know anode is positively charged, is it?
Yes, sir, because anions, that cation.
So chlorine ion will travel toward the anode. So what that chlorine ion will do? Chlorine will lose electron. Will lose electron in order to form chlorine gas. Chlorine gas will release from here and will release two chlorine ion going to lose two electron and they will form chlorine gas, and chlorine gas bubble will release from anode. So I am writing here, wait a second, let me use another color. See, the these bubbles are for chlorine gas will release from here. Okay, these bubbles are for chlorine gas. Understood that one?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, next, what will be the reaction at cathode? So I'm writing here reaction at cathode. Reaction at cathode. See, cathode is negatively charged electrode. So positive charge ion, which is positive charge ion? Sodium ion. Okay.
Sodium ion.
Yes. Sodium ion will gain these electrons which are lost by chlorine. So electron will travel from here like this, here, then here, here, through the circuit. Okay. And will reach on cathode and make it more negative. We know cathode is negatively charged. And when electron will travel from anode to cathode, will make cathode more negative. So will sodium ion, which is positively charged ion, will strongly attracted by the cathode because it becomes more negative. And from there, those electrons which are lost by chlorine will gain by sodium. And sodium metal will form, and sodium will form at solid state. Okay, and that will settle down at the bottom. Okay, so let me use another ink for that. I'm using the red one. Sir, okay, so haan beta,
sir, will that sodium which is first formed in the solid form, mm-hmm, again react with that water or the aqueous solution?
There is a probability, but generally that water used here, which is in ionic form. Okay, so yes, will react with water.
Okay, sir.
Okay, so if we are not using aqueous solution, then we can use molten NaCl also, molten one. Okay, because we need,
yes, sir, because that bond, it is necessary, yes, to be broken for that.
Yes, we want ions only. Okay, so maybe we will take aqueous one, because we have the salt, so we can perform that reaction at laboratory also. Or we can use molten NaCl. Molten NaCl we can use also. Okay?
Sir, but in that molten NaCl, won't that anode and cathode will melt?
No, because we are using the different substance. Because we are using such cathode electrode, they have higher melting point than the metal we are using there. So this generally, okay,
what is the electrode made of?
They, according to the requirement, we use different electrode beta. They may be made up of carbon also. Like in extraction of aluminium, we are using carbon electrode.
In that dry battery electricity, yes, there also carbon is only used, yes, that electrode, yes,
in the form of graphite. Graphite electrodes are being used. Yes. Okay. So according to the requirement, we are using different electrodes. Okay, in different cell. Okay. So where were we? Okay. So here at cathode, sodium metal will get deposited here. Okay, and that is called as sodium mud. Na mud. Okay. And that can be separated, dried, and ignited in order to form pure sodium. Okay, understood everyone? This is the electrolytic. And in
sir, understood.
Yes, very special reaction about electrolytic reduction is it do not require like refine or purification, because we are getting 99.99% of pure metal by electrolytic reduction, or we can say sometimes 100% pure metal we are getting by electrolytic reduction.
Gold is refined by
refining process, like, you know, when we used to extract metal, they also contain some impurities. So that impurities is going to remove by the refining process or purification process, we can say.
Sir, gold is metallized by which process, sir?
Gold have, like, it is a very less reactive, so it is by using hydrometallurgy only. It is by pyrometallurgy. Because gold do not contain much impurity because it is noble metal. So it do not.
Sir, can you zoom out? Zoom in a little.
Yes. Wait a second. Okay, wait a second. Let me.
Sir, should you also draw this diagram in a notebook?
If you want to understand deep what is electrometallurgy, so you can. Yes. And whenever if you are getting any doubt, that video will be present on your
Sir, can you show metallurgy part? I want to take a screenshot.
Have you taken screenshot, everyone, that part?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this process is called as electrolytic reduction of... See, why it is called as reduction? Because sodium gains electron here. Here, sodium gains electron, and the reaction in which any species will gain electron is called as reduction. That's why it is called as electrolytic reduction of sodium. Understood? Electrolytic reduction of sodium. Okay, this is the heading for that. Have you taken a screenshot, everyone? Everyone, do reply, beta.
Sir, 2 minutes, sir.
2 minutes, very long time.
Sir, done, sir.
Okay, wait a second. Let me just move the screen aside so that you can take full screenshot. Let me little zoom in. Yeah. Okay, now take a screenshot for that. So here we have completed metallurgy and types of metallurgy.
Yes, sir.
Okay, now I am going to ask you about doubts. Yes, any doubt?